Hi everybody, welcome to Big OGGIE Golf. Welcome back to Dan Hendriksen.
Welcome everybody, Cheerson Golf Club.
At Cheerson Golf Club. Happy New Year, Dan.
Might be a bit, Happy New Year, John. Might be a bit noisy today because the road is just a bit busy.
And it's windy.
And it's windy.
And it's going to rain. It's Devon. It always rains in Devon, right?
Always, yeah. Sorry. Yeah, you're right. It doesn't rain in Cornwall, rains in Devon.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Okay. And they put the price up on the bridge, 60p.
No, Devon, Devon.
£2.60 to get over the bridge, Dan.
Well, to get in which side? Into Devon?
To get into Devon, yeah. Okay. It's always free to come into Cornwall. We let you in. We just don't let you out.
So what are we doing today?
A lot of people on the channel have been asking me to do a putting video. Explain how I putt.
Okay.
I'm a high handicapper, mate. I can't teach you how to putt. So I brought in someone who is more of a coach.
So you want to talk about your putting and explain maybe a little bit about that to the audience?
Well,
is that what you're thinking?
My problem is I feel I'm a natural putter. So I don't think too much about technique, etc. I just kind of try and relax. I know me and you, the first video, we didn't do a video, but the first time I met you to do a lesson.
Yeah, we did a putting session.
We did a putting session. Yeah. And you talked to me about being more stable.
Yeah.
So that's all I really think about now, body stability.
Yeah, really important. You were a big swayer. John was a big mover on the putts, which was the problem with that, John, is that you were getting inconsistency of striking.
Yeah.
So sometimes you would, you know, strike it in the toe, sometimes you strike it low in the face, so getting inconsistency of that is obviously going to affect ball speed off the face, which can affect pace putting.
Okay.
But also, talking about pace putting, you know, if you're getting momentum, if you're using your body momentum going into the putt, then that can affect your pace control as well. So that's why we did that.
Yeah, I'm not a subtle putter, look at me. I mean, I'm subtle with paint, but I'm not subtle with playing golf. So the other reason I changed my putter as well, very, very quickly, because we're going to get on with this little lesson. When I first started, the pro I was with at the time let me borrow his spare putter. I never had any golf clubs.
Okay.
It was a tailor-made spider putter that was counterweighted.
Yeah.
And I couldn't get on with it. I assumed it was a bit like a hammer on the end of a stick. I had no control of it.
Okay.
Like a club hammer on the end of a stick.
Yep.
So, you know, I went into the shop and I looked at lovely ones and people were going, oh, you'll have a Scotty. So I had a bit of money. I sold a painting, so let's get one.
Okay.
And I enjoyed it and I've always enjoyed it. I've still got it. I've never sold it.
Never sell it.
But I just find it shorter putts, say 2 feet in, whether it's nerves because I feel more pressure with shorter putts, but I don't think, see, that kind of wobbling was happening.
Yeah, okay.
Didn't seem like stability. That could be me, could be that.
So obviously this is the same putter that I would use. This is 35, mine's 34, but it's pretty much the same putter.
Okay.
You've got, this is a bit of toe hang, so there's a little bit of toe hang in this one, and what I mean by that is that sometimes you're going to get a face balance putter, sometimes you're going to get a full toe hang, but this one kind of sits mid toe hang position, which enables the putter to just almost like what Scotty would say, maybe a little bit of flow in it, so toe flow, so the putter wants to kind of open and close itself down. If you pull on that putter's going to want to possibly open up fractionally as you pull on it on the way down, so you've got to be mindful of that. But one thing I have noticed with this putter, and I don't know if everyone can see kind of down the lens there, but the grip is a little bit skew-iff.
Yeah,
so I don't know if you've noticed that. Well, I mean, you were a good putter with this, so I don't know if that's going to affect
it was fitted by the point in the fact you went in the pro shop
and collected
it. He gave
it.
You a few little hits onto it in a little mat and went, oh, I think he said that about you need a slightly different toe or whatever. Because I was trying to force the other one straight.
Okay.
And that wasn't my arc or whatever on it. And that was all that happened. So this just basically came out of the shop. I've got one of those little grips on it because I had a bad back, but that was all.
So as you would set up to this putter, okay, if I was going to grip this putter, this grip is actually slightly what I would call open to the face.
Okay.
So it's aiming this way. So this is kind of the flat part of the putter here. That's aiming down here. So what that means is if you were to set up with this and had it square in your hands, then that putter is probably going to sit closed.
Right.
And it might be that you're talking about like the fact that it's twisting a little bit. It might be that you're just trying to almost like trying to get the face
back
square. So be mindful of that. Whenever you pick up a putter in the pro shop, just look down the line of the putter, make sure that the grip is on straight.
In a weird way, it's like when you pick up a snooker cue from the snooker club and you look at them and everyone rolls them on the table and they're all a bit wonky.
Yeah, they're a bit bent or whatever. But that's an interesting one. But then, talk about this one then.
So, I won this putter. I won two Seymour putters.
Yeah.
Gave one away.
Okay.
Went to get this fitted with Andy Gorman. And decided I like this particular putter. I was very lucky, a YouTuber, whatever, it happens.
Yeah.
Carbon Mac were involved as well, and they looked at me and said, look, we're going to give you a carbon max shaft and have it fitted in.
Yeah.
I know very little about them, but they're supposed to be very, very stable. That's the whole key. But the main thing that we changed was that it's a lot longer.
Yeah.
I get a lot of back problems, obviously. Yeah. I'm a big lad.
Yeah.
And I found that practicing with a Scotty was just impossible.
Yeah, okay.
A few minutes and you're just too painful. Yeah. Hence why I've got that little kind of grip on there to pull balls out of the hole. So,
well, big difference, these two putters, because obviously we talk about face balance. So this one, if I hang that, you can see that the toe doesn't want to drop like it does on the Scotty. It just kind of wants to sit pretty square there. Yep. And also, it's consistent heavy weight right the way through.
Yeah, so it's not like a counterbalance where it was at one end.
Okay, so for me, very different in the fact that obviously the way in which the putter is going to perform when you're going to be more straight back, straight through with this kind of putter, that face is not going to want to sort of twist too much like it would, let's say, in the Scotty. But also just the weight of it.
Yeah.
Just the fact that it feels, I've not had a putt with it yet, but it just feels like quite an easy putter to use.
Yeah, and that's one reason why I like it.
Yeah, and that's half the battle. You know, you've got to find a putter that you kind of like the look of. How's it feel in your hands? How's the grip feel? These are really important factors.
It's a confidence thing with putting, isn't it?
Of course it is. Absolutely right.
I know the other thing with Seymour, because people will say, oh, Seymour putter, they've got this rifling idea where you can aim down the shaft. You're going to see this on there. They've got little rifling so you can tell if it's straight, basically. You can't do that very well with this particular design and that shaft, because that shaft's thicker than a normal shaft.
Right.
So I don't really use that
side of it.
So I've never really been someone who can kind of look down a club and then work out where I'm going. I'm very much a feel and look and hit.
Yeah.
Because that's my handicap level.
Okay. Well, should we just hit a few putts and and see what you're doing?
Happens.
Well, let's see what you're doing well.
Yeah.
And let's see what... Hopefully
some things well.
And then those things we might be able to pass over to the audience.
Okay. Sounds good to me.
So I've got you a putt here of around, what's that, 8 feet? 10 feet?
It looks longer, but yeah, okay.
Let's say 10 feet. Yeah. So I've got a 10-foot putt here. Where would you say your positives are on a putting point? Would you say you're good from this range? Are you good from short? Are you better from long?
Well, I'd like to think I'm good from that range.
Okay, from your experience of playing and editing and watching yourself on camera, which bit do you
people
think is...
People will say my longer putts are good.
As in your pace putting?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's always about getting... To me, see, this is the difference. In my level, if I can get on the green and a reasonable amount of shots...
Yeah.
I've got two.
Okay.
I've got at least two probably on the green.
Yeah.
Maybe three. Never know. So for me, it's not always about getting in the hole in one.
Yeah.
It's just getting close enough to tap in.
Yeah, of course. And not getting too excited. I see lots of players want to run these putts past a lot of the time, which is in some ways is a good thing because you get to see the break of the putt once it gets past the hole. But actually, you know, cozying it up, get your two putt, move on, and then you might get the odd one that drops in.
Well, my fault normally, and we won't know about that until I hit a ball, is they don't go past the hole.
Okay, so you're
I know on your Christmas special, if you watch that, I was actually quite disappointed that none of mine went in. You know, we were all lovely lining them up, and they were just short and short. But I'm playing safe to get it near the hole.
Sometimes playing safe's not a bad thing, as you know, from that Christmas special. Right, which putt are we going to go with first? Which one do you want? We're better off showcasing what you're doing with your Seymour.
The real one, I guess. Yeah, I just wanted to kind of show why I got from the Scotty, which is... No one goes from a Scotty. But it's length. It's length and stability. That was what it was about.
Okay, let me see a few putts and see what you're up to. This putt is just going to move probably off this left edge. You're right for you?
Okay. So, theoretically, I'm supposed to line up with...
Turn around.
Yeah, theoretically, I'm supposed to line up. But filming, I never do. I never have time.
No. Well, that's an interesting thing. So, let's just hit a few putts. Okay. I'll explain a bit about that in just a moment.
Okay. So I'm just going to hit the ball. Yeah.
Yeah. Just how you would normally, John. So slightly downhill at your left hand side, fractionally.
Okay. So I've not even hit a ball today. So I don't know how fast this green is.
They've just been hand cut. So these are quite quick today.
I was thinking,
it is slightly downhill as well.
Okay. Okay.
Good.
Now, see, I'd still be very happy with those because to me, they're not tap-ins, but they're
but
realistically okay.
Again, your start position is probably a little bit. It's looking like it's moving. If you're going dead weight, you need to be out this side here.
See, I'm panicking.
That's a killer because you're now left with a nasty 2 footer down the hill there, aren't you?
Okay.
Okay.
Interestingly, I'm not picking up the reed going left to right all the time.
Across there. Okay, one thing I do want to sort of point out with people is, so, you know, one thing you'll notice from this, when John sets up to this putt, is that with this particular putter that he's got, is he, his eyes are not directly over the ball.
No.
So with this putter and the length of it and the arc of it, it's pulling you kind of further away from the ball. But actually, that's not necessarily a bad thing when it comes to some golfers. Some golfers, you know, like the fact that they will create more of an arc in that way. So what's going to happen is, if you get a player that's got their eyes directly over the ball, you're generally going to find the arc is naturally going to, as their shoulders rotate, is naturally going to want to try to work its way inside. If you're too far this way inside the ball line, so your eyes are kind of inside the line, you tend to find that the arc of the putter will move quite actively from there, because of the way in which the angle of which the shaft is in that position. If you're too much the other way, so if your eyes are over the, over this side, you'll generally find that your arc may move kind of this way as you come back and through. Okay, so that's just a reference point, and a good way to do that when it comes to, you know, how do I know which one kind of am I, is get yourself set up over the ball and then just simply drop a ball from your eye line here, just drop it down and see where you're at. And if you want to get, you know, if your arc is maybe too severe and you're maybe just inside the line, then maybe you could just get yourself to almost like cover the ball a little bit more, stand a little closer.
Okay.
And the opposite, if you're too much out there or too much over it, then your arc may move a little bit, almost two squares.
Can we do that again? I'm just going to film that on this little phone, just so we can kind of show that happening when you drop the ball. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. I think giving me a downhill putt is a bit iffy, but, you know.
Yeah, no, that's fine. But again, it's not a putt that you want to be racing past, but no, it's certainly one that you want to almost like try and feel like you're falling it into this corner here as you come into the putt. So you're sort of dying it in there. Better putt.
Kind of like
again,
that,
that's not running away too far, is it? So that's a good putt.
Just all random.
Something we talked about before, John,
all
right, was don't be nosy.
Yeah.
And what I mean by that is, you can always find somebody who's not an overly confident putter. Like, you just watch them. Watch their actions, their mannerisms around the putt. And as soon as you hit the putt, you're wanting
to
follow.
Are you looking to see what happens?
Yeah.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
a good way, if you're somebody that maybe struggles with a bit of anxiousness on putting, someone like, they feel like they've got the yips or something along those, like, I'm not saying you have, but some people may be watching.
Oh, I'm anxious because the camera's on.
Oh, okay,
And you're putting, so
what I always do is I find a blade of grass between my putter face and the ball, between the two. And then what I do is, as I hit that ball come through, I look for that blade of grass.
Okay.
So that makes me keep my body in a position, because all you're doing is, as you're coming through, you're looking, but
you're looking for the result.
And I'm not a big one for saying, you know, keep your head down, because that's not what I want to do, but your body moves up with the shot.
Yeah.
You're coming up and out of your putts, which is, you know, all your putts are wanting to leak off to the right-hand side here. Let's focus on just trying to commit to the putt.
Okay.
All right, don't worry about where it goes. Almost listen for it to go into the hole from there. So find that blade of grass between putter, face and ball, and then look for that as it comes through. Just a solid, really, really solid putt. And, you know, you're keeping your body in a nice static position, as we talked about previously. So much better, John. So much better. Again.
Because I'm not now thinking about up here, up this end.
No.
Your focal point.
Once you've done your homework, which is your homework is your alignment and how your pace you're going to hit it. And now it's just a case of keeping that body in a good position, allowing that putter to roll through. Okay, keep it up. Let's get it up this left-hand side just a little bit more. And let's just feel like you're going to... That was a good pace. Just feel like you're falling it into that front left-hand door for you. Just a good putt. Solid putt.
Oh, see?
Not doing much damage with that. Well, but what I like is, you're not anxious.
I don't mind admitting this. Sometimes when we do pro tips on the channel, and someone... Like, we talk to a lot of pros, and they go, oh, I'm going to do a putting tip or whatever.
Yeah.
We'll re-edit. We'll do it again and again and again, because they don't want to see that.
No.
But actually, I'm very happy with that, because that's your two putts. You're on the green. Yeah. You get it close.
You're not
20 feet past or 10 feet past.
The chances of you holding that putt
Yeah.
Even if it was dead straight and dead flat, your percentages would be actually a lot lower than you think.
But do you think that's part of the problem with golf? Especially,
yeah.
Well, majority of golfers, they think, because they watch golf on the TV,
yeah,
they're seeing the best putts. They're not
they
seeing
are.
The
they're
bad
not, you're
misses.
Not seeing the guy who's struggling to make the cut.
Yeah.
Who's missing all of these
and
all day long.
They're probably only going to see the good ones because they've never even
those. Because that's the story, isn't it? You know, that's the story. That's what they want to showcase.
They just assume we're going to get those in every time.
Absolutely. But the chat, you're not... If you hold this, think of it
that's
as a bonus.
Bonus. Absolutely.
You know, you're just trying to get yourself into a position where you two-putt, and if it drops in, great.
Yeah.
Okay? Especially, you know, with your handicap, if it drops in, fantastic. You're not going to be... Don't get yourself into a position where you chase it, because even if you three-putt, it doesn't matter, but if you chase it and you three-putt, there's nothing more annoying than a three-putt.
Yeah, that messes up your head for the
next... It messes up your next couple of holes, probably. So
and if I'm too hard on a downhill putt and I'm 6 foot back, suddenly... There's a pressure coming the other way.
Of course it is. And that's just building up with that anxious feel on you from there.
Okay,
keep it up that left-hand side, John. Keep it up the left.
Am I up the left? Because this
no,
is my
you're
eye,
you're,
if you see.
Your blue line on the back of your putter
yep.
is aiming kind of left edge of the hole.
See, this is another discussion. I don't really want to B-roll here.
Yeah.
I am very right eye dominant.
Okay.
Like 100% and 10%. Literally no... left.
Yeah.
So even when I tee up, people are going, "Oh, you're putting your tee in the wrong
position."
If you're
not going to line the ball up, which
position.
Is fine, just come back and just pop the shaft over the top of the ball. Look at where you want it to line to, and then pick your spot.
Okay.
Just in front there, get your putter aligned to that spot.
Yeah.
Then that's your homework, isn't it?
Okay.
Good, much better.
See, to me, that looks like here.
Yeah, yeah, well, it's
looking
a swinging
right
putt. I mean, it is moving. The wind's, okay. It's a quick green. The wind's going to push it a fraction as well. And again, don't look for the ball. Don't be nosy.
yeah.
It was a little bit pacey, but...
Yeah,
but
well, it was, but it was the right direction.
Correct.
Okay.
Don't be nosy. Started it a little low.
A little bit low. I panicked there because it was a little bit fast on the last one. So
yeah,
I kind
okay.
of adjusted myself.
But it went in. Again, right. Just hold it there.
Should
That's
be there,
it.
Shouldn't
come,
it?
Come back. Take your time.
Yeah.
You know, come back. Look at your point. Every time this is why I always come on the green with one ball. Because you're going to get one chance.
This is another thing. When you're practicing.
Yeah.
Quite often, you just get a pile of balls, and you're standing in the same spot, and you'll miss, and you'll just adjust, and you'll miss, and you'll adjust, and you'll miss.
Yeah.
Until you get them in. That isn't golf.
No.
Golf is the way it said, one ball.
One ball, one opportunity, go through the process and then just move around the putting green as you do it, you know?
Okay.
Pick your spot. Once you've got your alignment spot, then you've done your homework bit. That's good. Now focus on, it's a little bit left, a little bit more. That's it, good. And because you're going to die in the front door. Pick your spot between face and ball and then let it go from there. And then, you know, it's still wanting to go.
Yeah. Okay, that's fine.
Another one is, you know, let's focus on possibly the line of the ball as well. And I know when you're filming, you don't have a chance to do this, but this is a good one. Get that putter lined up, the blue line in line with that. That's a good spot. Again, pick your spot.
A little harder, it was just going to come
round.
Short
in your backswing, but all in all, pretty good.
Okay.
What I like about this is your body. Is now nice and static.
Yeah.
Whereas in previous sessions you were wobbly, moving with it. You're now in a position where you've focused on that and you've got it right.
That's the thing I've always been trying to work on since we first spoke.
Yeah.
Even when I'm filming, sometimes you're rushing, you're by yourself and you're running up and you can, oh, I don't have time to line up, but we're going to crack an appeal behind and I'll.
Yeah, of course.
But I still try and keep that body stable.
Yeah.
Irrespective of what else happens.
I'm putting out on in vlogs, shall we say, I'm not lining up like I would in a tournament.
Yeah.
I'm just taking... Because I use the line in a tournament and things like that, because I've got more time to prepare myself for that. In a vlog, I've got to keep up with the pace of play. I've got cameras to deal with, people around me, you know. So, don't be... You know, but when you come to playing in competitions, go through that process.
Okay.
Should we have a few longer putts?
Yeah, okay.
Let's see how you fare on those.
Okay.
So I've just paced that out. You've got 14 paces.
Okay.
So probably about a 14 meter putt, okay?
Okay.
Uphill, slightly out of the left fractionally. Now, yep. You talked about pace control is your kind of like key thing. You know, you're good at pace control.
Okay.
Anything you focus on when you're doing the putt like this? Are you reading things into it?
I try and read a little bit.
Yeah.
My thought process on most long putts is aim straight.
Literally
aim straight.
Straight to the hole?
If I'm looking for it, yeah.
Okay.
Because quite often on some courses, there's so much left and right and whatever.
Yeah.
If you've got the pace right, yeah. It takes out a lot of those.
Yeah,
sometimes
okay.
If you're trying to read perfect okay. positions,
yeah.
You have to know where you're going to, where it's going to drop off the hill or whatever.
Okay.
Yeah. Remember in your Christmas special, no, the one when you came to West Cornwall, I just hit it really hard. Yes, I did kind of know where some of those bars were, but it was like aim straight.
Yeah, okay.
A bit hard, but yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And sometimes you get away with it.
Okay, well
it's not for me to get in the hole.
Let me see you hit a couple of these putts,
okay.
and then we'll talk about what you're up to.
Okay. And the other thing I do try and do is I just try and keep things steady.
Okay.
Mental stuff. So I don't go like quickly suddenly put power on it because it's further away.
Yeah.
It's more about trying to keep a steady pendulum,
okay.
really.
I'll just zoom you back out,
okay.
and then I'll come back down and we'll hit a putt again, all right?
Okay. So I'm going to vaguely go a little bit with the line.
Okay.
So we're thinking left to right.
It's definitely going to move a little bit there. I mean, it's all uphill at the beginning, and then it wants to flatten out a little bit. Yeah, only a little bit, but it's...
Okay.
Yeah, I mean... Where you've got that line is not bad. I think it's pretty straight up that hill, to be fair. It's going to move a little bit from right to left at the beginning and then want to come back again at the end. Okay, great for weight. Really
great
good.
For weight. To me, that's great for weight.
Yeah.
But obviously line isn't necessarily correct.
3 foot uphill putt, pretty straight, to be fair.
Okay.
Fantastic for weight. That's a good alignment like
that. Yeah, because I'm now thinking wind is also pulling.
Wind's going to go and kick in. These greens, like I said earlier, have been hand cut, so.
A little bit short, that one, okay.
Interestingly, the further left you go, the more uphill it is.
Yeah.
Because you're going, actually a bit of a steeper slope just there.
So to me, that's now right in the way. That's
you're kind of going around it.
You reckon around on the outside?
Just around the outside of it. And if your pace goes up a bit, that ball won't break as early and it won't hit that ball.
Yeah, I can't get that pace now.
Don't be nosy. You're nosy
again
now.
Yeah, I looked again.
Okay, you looked up.
Because I was worried about that ball. I'm thinking, oh.
Well, your strike went.
Yeah,
because you were nosy, you struck it poorly, so your ball speed drops off and you've not got the pace then.
Okay.
Much better. Much better putt.
I take that. Curls around the back of it and.
Yeah. And again, don't try and feel like you have to hit it, John. Just lengthen the backswing slightly. Don't feel like you have to force it up the hill. Better. Lovely. Good strike. In you go.
Close, isn't it?
I prefer that. I don't want to see what I see with you a lot of the time is just the sense that you're like a lot of people. You're tending to want to go a little bit short on the way back and then accelerate
and then accelerate
through with your body moving, as in not moving like it was in the previous sessions that we've had, but more that your body's up looking, getting that nosy action as you come through. So just want to get you to get the sense of maybe getting the feeling like it's a little bit longer, just not feel like you're changing the speed too much, like hitting at it, but just lengthen that stroke a little bit more on the way back. That last put your hips spot on.
See, even though I said right at the start of these long ones that I do try and keep a pendulum.
Yeah.
There is still, I might go back, but I kind of just rush it a little bit on that.
And
when
definitely
it goes to impact.
You're going
to
get that when you come to a big slope like this one.
Because you want to get up that slope.
Because you want to hit it up that hill. The amount of people that I see either, you know, a lot of the time they don't get it at the top of the hill, but for the most part, they go firing way past because they hit it just that little bit harder because of that slope.
You want to get over that bit.
Exactly. Just build the slope into your putt. Build the speed into it from there.
Okay.
And then take it from there.
So keep steady all the way through.
All the way through. Pendulum.
Pendulum.
Get in there. Bang. Hole.
Yeah.
Nailed it a little bit, and that's something you're going to have to work on.
Yep. Right. So again, from those kind of distances up a hill on a green I've never been on in my life.
Yep. Not bad.
They're not bad. I know I've got a long handled putter, but to me, if they're a bit inside, kind of around that area, I'm in with a chance.
Again, with what you got to think about with a putt like this is, again, don't try and feel like you've got to hole it or it's always going to be a two putt. The chances of you know, two putt is great, and then the more you practice and the more you get used to a green like this, then that's going to happen a little bit more. But you're going to three putt some of these. Like, that's the reality.
Sure.
You know, if you start thinking of this as maybe a scratch golfer, that's slightly different because the skill level is probably a little bit higher when it comes to putting and certainly long distance putting. But for your handicap, you know, if you're getting for the most part two putts from here, fantastic. If you get the odd three putt, don't be hard on yourself because you've got onto a green that's this big and you've ended up three putting. It's gonna happen.
Yeah.
And it's accepting that. When you get a putt of this length with all the contours, different if it's dead flat, but if you get with all these contours and you get a three putt, it's going to happen.
Yeah.
All right. But okay. What I like is the fact that let's not focus on short stabby and smash it through. Let's focus on trying to get the sense of using that pendulum. And the more you do it, the better you'll become at it. And it's a new skill as such.
It's a new skill. It's a bit like when we've done irons and driver and everything. When I try and force things, it goes out of control.
Yeah.
When I keep that smooth swing, it's amazing how much better.
Well, because you saw it for yourself there, when you got snatchy, when you got quick on it, when you came up looking for it, your strike failed.
Yeah. Could be way back or
and that doesn't matter whether it's a driver, an iron, a chip, a putt. If your strike goes, strike is king.
Yeah.
Okay? You're gonna be an inconsistent golfer if you can't continuously get a decent strike. This is what makes those guys that you watch on TV so good and why they hit so many balls. Is because they're after strike all the time.
Yeah.
And if your strike goes, your performance is going to go. So let's get strike consistent.
Okay.
And then you can start working on, you know, your different views of putts and all of those sorts of things around. And that's probably some of the key points. The two key points I want you to focus on really today is, let's not get nosy on it.
Yeah, that's the key one for me. That's actually going to be the title of this video. That's going to be the title.
Yeah, because let's not get looking for it, because we're all anxious on certain putts. We're all anxious on certain shots. If you're somebody who struggles, let's say, with a driver off the tee or struggle chipping, you're going to be up looking quickly. Okay, you're the same with putting. Don't come up looking for it. Do your homework, figure out how fast you want to hit it, figure out where you will need to hit it to for your aim point, and then accept what happens before you hit the putt.
Okay.
Once you've hit that putt, gone through it, there's nothing you can do, but if your body changes its position, your strike is going to go and you're going to fail with the putt.
Make sense to me?
Long distance, just make sure you get that pendulum. Let's try and not hit the putt. Let's try and focus on letting that putter roll back and roll through. I think I'm quite happy with what you're using.
Yeah, I'm happy with it. I understand. I've got body limitations, and my back is damaged from playing rugby for many years.
Yeah.
So I am quite upright. I understand that, and I know we will do. I'd like to think we'll come back and do a video about some practice techniques, etc. Yeah. Maybe some practice games, putting games, things.
Yeah.
But right now, it was just a general kind of opening up to the new year
and
going, this is kind of how I putt, and maybe we can just improve a little few things, which I think we've just done.
Yeah.
Because actually, I know we hit two, but they were all kind of just past, which I never normally get. They're normally short if they're going to be. If they're only going to be bad, it's going to be way short.
And what you should do as well, just be mindful of where the ball went past the hole. Don't look away in disgust. I see this again so often where people hit a putt, oh no, and they don't look at where the ball went. Watch it. Watch where it goes past the hole. It's giving you a free read.
So I'm saying, certainly with the longer ones, you've got time.
Yeah.
Once you've hit it and you finish the stroke, then look up, because then you've got time to watch what happens to it.
For the most part, you're going to see the ball generally go past the hole by the time you've kind of, you remember, you're listening for it with the shorter ones. A really good one as well for those short putts, you know, those ones that people do, the knee knockers, you know, the little touchy little two-footers.
The ones that go round the loop and nearly, do I go in or not?
You know, when you're hitting putts from here and just trying to tap in, again, don't be nosy, because most people miss putts because they've gone looking for it quite early. Who was it? Doug Sanders, was it, when he missed that putt at the Open back in 1960s against Jack Nicklaus, I think. You know, you watch him and he hits that putt, he's gone, he's looking for it, he wants it in the hole, you know. You know, we all do it, but just be, like you say, just focus on that strike position, make sure that putter comes back and through, and you'll be absolutely fine.
Okay, so, like I said, just a general video. We're ending it today because the weather's not great for a long video today.
Not great, but
thank you very much, Dan, for
allowing me to
do this today, and for coming on my channel, because it's great. It's an honour that you come on my channel.
No, I love it.
I'd hope you're back on yours at some point.
Yeah.
Okay.
We got to keep this southwest thing going, haven't we?
Well, we have. So I hope you might have learned something today. From my point of view, I've learned, absolutely the title of the video is not to be nosy.
Yeah.
Don't be nosy. Don't look at your result before they've got there.
Yeah.
And I think the other thing for me is, there's that. There is keep the pace through, back and forward.
Yeah.
Don't rush that little bit. But it's about trust. Trust yourself. So you don't, good putters don't even need to look at where they've gone, because they're just trusting them when they do that and that and that. That's what happens.
Absolutely right.
Trust it.
Absolutely
trust
right. Yourself. And remember, and it doesn't matter whether it's a putter, a driver, an iron, chipping, whatever, strike rules. Strike is king. That will make you a consistent ball striker, and then you'll get consistency in your pace control.
But above all, and this is for Simon Ford, because he's going to be watching this, I know he is, just enjoy it. Because it's golf and it's not going to kill you. It's just a golf ball. Yeah, you've had a bad day, go do it next day.
Don't most people do it as a hobby? Is this not a hobby?
Is this supposed to be fun? It is a hobby, isn't it?
But
it's a hobby that beats you up, but you always come back the next day to do it again.
Hope so.
Don't panic about putts, because, you're going to lose a few shots on putts. No one's perfect.
Accept it before you hit it.
Yeah. Thank you much, Dan.
My pleasure as always, John.
So we'll be back with Dan very soon. We're going to do some little practice putting things that we can do, little tips and some games maybe, just to get you back into it. But for now, we're gone. Bye everybody, please subscribe, please hit the notification bar, do all those things. Come and join Dan on his channel, me on my channel, and if you like food, come and join my other one, Big Oggie World, because we're growing up as well. Without that channel, we can't afford to come and pay Dan to do lovely things for me.
You've made me hungry now, John.
Thank you. Yeah, I know, I try. Bye everybody, speak soon.